It's the moment you've all been waiting for. Daniel and me, Mikey Pipes, we're gonna take out these Goodman 13 CR 410A condensers and put it to Bosch IDS 2.0 heat pumps. It's gonna be sick. Stick around, smash that thumbs up button. All right, right now, Daniel is pumping down. And by pump down, we're closing the liquid line right there. And we hopefully, the compressor is cooperating. And in this case, it's not really cooperating. Looks like we're gonna have to recover some. But normally on the old school days, when you didn't have the internal bypass on the compressor, you can close the liquid line and hook up your manifold gauges. The compressor will pump down all the refrigerant into the condensing coil, right? And then you can close the low side. All right, a little before 8:30 in the morning, there's the first condenser. Daniel's working on disconnecting the second that had no charge whatsoever. We recovered the remaining refrigerant that hasn't been pumped down into the condenser, condensing coil. And the goal here is, we're gonna clean up this area a little bit. We're going to make sure that the existing condenser pads are level. It's very important. You know, will it work if it's a little bit crooked? Absolutely. Does it look retarded if it's not at an angle like this? Yes. There's no there's no question about that. But it's a more professional job if you keep the work area clean, and when you set the equipment, it's nice and level. We're gonna get a little creative, I think, with the line sets. I'm contemplating whether or not we just follow the height coming out of the king valves on each unit, and then keeping that elevation to the elbows that we're gonna have, obviously add to go up to the penetration going through the house. But we'll see once we move the other unit out of the way and get the area cleaned up, getting the 4 foot level out, making sure the pads are level, and we'll take some. Now, if you recall on the last video when we were here to do a tune-up and an inspection of the HVAC equipment, which included the two furnaces. And I made note that both furnaces lacked neutralizers. And I let the homeowner know that, hey, listen, you may have PVC piping throughout the house, but once it gets to the ground, it's going to be cast iron. But if you don't have one of these neutralizers, right, you're going to eat the piping. And it's also bad for the waste treatment systems and, you know, the whole municipality, and bad for the environment as well. So we're putting in two Axiom neutralizers. These are the streakers. You feel like streaking? Streaker! All right, so this morning at 7:30 in the morning, Peter was at FWEB in Babylon. It is now 9 o'clock. He just pulled up. Let's take this stuff off the trucks.
All right. That's right. Thank you, Hashem. Giving us another day. Here we got. There's one Bosch for you, one Bosch for you. Awesome. There he is. A Bosch a day keeps Mikey Pipes away.
That's not good,
bro. No, it's not good. No.
Teamwork. Hard work.
The Bosch, baby. Dude, you're getting a Bosch. The guy yesterday, dude, you're not getting a Bosch. Yesterday, you got a Carrier.
Oh, yeah.
Infinity. By the way, I signed up. I'm paying him $4,000. Carrier factory authorized dealer. Yeah, you gotta pay them. Yep. But you get a plethora of benefits.
Yeah, I was gonna say, what are the perks?
We get priority technical support. The tech support is pretty good anyway,
yeah.
Right? But we get co-op. So for every dollar we spend, we get X amount of dollars back in co-op funds. So listen, if you factor in, you know, $500,000, put it right here for right now, $500,000 of equipment purchases a year, right? That's a nice, It's like a little baby Porsche payment. All right, so let me show you what we're doing so far. We got the two units already disconnected. We're gonna put one unit here on the high-rise heat pump pad. We're gonna put that one there, and we're gonna set up the other pad right in front of it, and then Daniel's gonna do his magic with the line set. It's gonna be epic, and it's gonna be mwah. All right, we have, you have the swedging tool. Nice, by field piece. Not for a field piece. Yellow jacket. We have the Hilmer bender, the bender. And you're going to put a little bend on that, aren't you?
How old is that swager?
That one? Swager. That one is about 15 years old. It works. Yeah. It works. It works on soft tube copper, the rolled copper. If you put that into the, you know, lengths of 20-foot pipe that we buy, it's going to, you know, split it open. So... there we go, very nice. And we're gonna make this look pretty. Look nice and nice and pretty. Mwah. Pretty. Right, Daniel?
Yep.
Okay. I am going on an emergency service call right now.
Oh, you're
gonna
do it?
Yes. I need to create great content. And it's not every day that we work on a Whale McLean Ultra 3, $399, that hasn't been serviced in almost 11 years. So it's, I already warned him. Be prepared. But listen, we leave no stone unturned. That's the kind of quality work that you get when you call Pipe Doctor Home Services based in Valley Stream, New York. Our phone number is 516-348-6300. My email address, you can reach me at either mike@mikeypipes.com or mike@pipedoc.net. And if you're viewing this video before Monday, the 6th of February, Daniel and I will be at AHR Expo in Atlanta. Maybe you'll see me around. I'll be wearing my Pipe Doctor swag and maybe even give some stickers. Stickers. So stick around and catch you on the next one. Be well. God bless. Stay safe. All right. Before I leave the job, head over to my next one last thing to do. There you go. Perfect. Bow. When you wake up in the morning, you should thank God that He has provided you with another day. You have a meal in front of you. Thank God He has provided for another day. You have a job. You can take care of your family, your loved ones. Thank God you're able to do that. Before you go to sleep, thank God for another amazing, epic day. Thanks for watching.
Okay, so got hot block on the king valves. Pulled the Schrader cores, got it on the filter dryer too, so that stays looking good. The steel will stay protected because we won't burn the paint off. Two solders back there were ugly because it was hard to get. But solder these in. That's fine. Staper ID. Silver solder. And there's one over there too. The other unit.
looks nice.
So we just finished up collected payment from the customer. We ran the systems, couldn't charge them exactly because we don't know the exact length, and we can't do subcooling in this temperature, but they were discharging heat. I added a rough ballpark of how much they need. If we need to adjust it, we can, but the line sets. Nice 45s, 90s, repeated on both. Nice and level the whole way.
There was some wire back there for heat pump, right?
Yeah, so there is 5 wire there to wire it up for heat pump at a later date, but right now we just ran 2 wire for the outdoor because that's all it's being used for. And that's it. We tested them, and they're good.